Hi there and welcome to another Disney Infinity video. I haven't recorded one of these in a very long time, but let's go straight into it. We are doing the Disney Infinity Big Racetrack. This is going to be fun. I'm going to take you through a couple of the toy boxes. Still working through the list, so we were still obsessed with the toy racetrack. This one actually was really hard, and I found that the thin ones were especially hard because you didn't have much room for error, whereas the wider tracks you could go all over the place. These ones required a little bit more expert control of the car, which is important. Alright, here we go. I'm going to start it off. Got my mechanic, Quora the mechanic. Here we go. Oh, nice. Here we go. Stay in fourth place. We bump someone off the road. Here we go. Up, down, see, go up. It's like three-dimensional. You go down underneath. You think it's up top, but it's not. It's below. Oh, man. I think I'm going to fall. I'm going to fall off the edge. It is just... it's so narrow. But then, you know, also, you can just cut corners in this race if you're really trying to win. Which is potentially what will happen, because I don't like losing. Here we go. Oh, what did I say? I fell off the edge. I can't believe I fell off the edge. Now here we go. This is a wobbly. Then we're turning. It takes a while to construct these things as well. I'm having Seattle's best coffee. All right, here we go. Lap one down, and we're in. Still in fourth place. Fourth place. Oh no, am I going over the edge? No, I didn't do that this time. No, nice. I hadn't played this in such a long time when I recorded this that I forgot the controls a little bit, so it took me a while to figure those out. Here we go. No, too fast! Oh, just saved from the edge. That was close. Now we're in third place still. But this is where I think I'm going to cut corners, I think. There we go. Yeah, let's cut this corner and beat this person. There we are. Now we're in second place. There we go. Nice. No. Ooh, that was close. Oh, we just cut it. Look. How bad is that? How bad is that? Oh, my word. Kids, do not cheat. Not a good idea. Let me go up here. Turning. Come on, we can do it. I'm second place though. How am I second place? This made her ahead of me. Made her beat me by a long shot. Where did Nader go? So they're gonna have a look around. There's also an underground passage. And a castle. Isn't that cool? All these things, remember all these toy boxes you could attach. You had to obviously complete certain missions to get them, but you got everything eventually. Castle, it looks like it's been rearranged. And Baymax is so good because he flies like this. This is awesome. Real top dude. Now let's go on in the tunnels. Alex and I played in this toy box a little bit, so that's why I'm going through it all. The great thing about these videos now is you can record your worlds in video games, that the ones you've created, and now it's there. You don't miss out on it. Of course, you'd love to boot up the system and play it, but there's not the need because you actually have it recorded. All right. Now we're going to the next section, which is there's two worlds. Alex played and built on one side. I built on the other, and then we built this sort of conveyor belt that moved shapes around the world. And then Alex liked the slides and the buildings. I still had the toy box where you had to kill a certain number of people because they have enemies. But we played this one quite a bit because of it was very odd and different. And this is the slide. Alex's slide. It just went up and down and all around. And then it'd be flying again. Car park. We like the car park. We like to stack a bunch of car parks together. And used to have crops growing there. This is one of the platforms. So with the basic shapes, you can actually put them on little trajectories around the map to have them move, which made it interesting. It made it more like, whatchamacallit, Mario Brothers. There we go. I don't know what this does. I think it did something a long time ago, but I don't know. I think it may reset the platforms or do something. Anyway, then we got the cannon. Cannon one was one of the later toys that we won playing. I think it was the Disney Takeover series where you could play with anyone. Another slide. I built my own slide. And look, flew off right into a thing. Now I'm gonna go and change the background. That's one thing, you could change the background all the time. That was fun. Pressing that, I think, activated the music system. Play different theme music. I think that's Isengard. The place where Thor lived. Okay, this one is the toy box to shoot the monsters. So we're gonna have a bit of a fight here. I think like a destroyer droid to start the day. He obviously has a defense shield that you have to punch through. Oh, nice punch. He's a very slow runner though. He's the slowest runner, I think. Big lumbering steps. There's someone out there. Let's go find him. He's hiding. Where are you? In my forest. Oh, there he is. Nice! We got him! Yes! And then that's the end. So thank you very much for watching these two tours of the toy box. All right then, bye!